A warm good morning to all. Welcome to the computer online class. Hope all of you safe and enjoying your long holidays. Today I am going to steal your 15 minutes for this class. Keep watching and listen the class. Let's move on to the first lesson. The first lesson topic is computer system. All of you know about computer. Most of you using computer, mobile, laptop, day to your life. Current generation children, they well known about the electronic gadget. Most of you using the computer only for playing games and watching movie. So you won't see what are the devices need to run the computer, what are the things available in the computer. So, in this lesson, we are going to see some more information about the computer. In this chapter, we are going to learn under the four subheading. First one is classifications of computer by size. Second one is hardware. Third one is software. And finally, computer language. Today we are going to see the classifications of the computer by size and the hardware part. Under this classifications of computer by size, there are five categories there. First one, mobile computer. Second one, microcomputer, then mini computer, mainframe computer, last is the supercomputer. First we will discuss about the mobile computer. You all are know about the mobile computer. These are the smallest computer designs to be carried around by the user. Example, we can say the laptop. No need the brief explanation about these things because you all are know the usage of the things. Laptop is the portable version. There are many varieties of laptop is available. First one is the netbook. Comparing the laptop and the netbook, netbook is small. The difference is netbook does not have the DVD drive, but both are capable of running the same software. And another one is ultrabook. Comparing the laptop, the ultrabook is very slimmer and lighter, but everything is built to offer the same performance as a laptop. Next device is the tablet. Everyone know what is tablet, am I right? Can you say what are the difference of the laptop and the tablet? Yes, your guess is correct. It is easy to identify. They comes without a keyboard and the mouse. Then how we can operate without the keyboard? We can operate it via the touch screen. The next device is a smartphone. Everyone know about smartphone. Everybody's nowadays, most of the kids were using the smartphone. So through the smartphone only you are listening my teaching, right? So no need of any brief explanation about this. Most of them know how to handle this smartphone. Next one is ebook reader. This ebook reader is used to store and read the books, newspapers and magazine. Through this ebook reader we can read these things. Next device is the PMB device. The full form of PMB is portable media player. This is used to hearing the music, images, video and etc. If you have any free time, if you have a leisure time, you can hear the music. We can get some peaceful mind. Through this PMB device, we can hear the music, videos and the images. Next thing is the laptop-tablet hybrid. It is the combination of both tablet and laptop. We can use it for both. both you can use it in the single device. Next we will see about the microcomputer. This is the small in size. It is used by one person at a time. We can use this microcomputer in office, school, colleges and committees. Nothing but we are using the computer, the desktop computer, that is called as the microcomputer. Also we can call it as a personal computer or PC. The next category of this one is the mini computer. This mini computer is larger than the microcomputer. We can say the size of this computer is like a refrigerator size, same as the refrigerator. This one is introduced in the year 1960s. After that, in 1980, this mini computer is replaced by the microcomputer. Why means the size of the mini computer is much large comparing the microcomputer, because we couldn't able to carry this mini computer to somewhere else. So that in 1980s it will replaced by the microcomputer. The example of the mini computer is Microvax 3100, HP 2000. The next device is the mainframe computer. While seeing the picture itself, we can easily say it's very big, powerful and more expensive multi-user computer, which means many of them can operate this computer. Compare the microcomputer only one person we can operate the computer at a time, but this one is not like that. This computer is used for the government office purpose, airlines and bank. Example, we can say IBM 4381, DEC 10, NEC 610. The last one is the supercomputer. Supercomputer is the biggest computer comparing all the other computer. It's more powerful computer. How much big this one means? It can occupy the entire room. That much big. So the process also very high. The trillions of the instruction we can do it in per second. Itself we can do it. The use of the supercomputer, the government organizations and the large industries were using this supercomputer. For what purpose? That required a lot of numeric calculations such as weather forecasting. Example, we can say IBM, Sequoia, Fujitsu, K. These are the some example of the super. Hardware device, the physical component which we can see and touch is called the hardware devices. From the word itself, we can easily identify what are the things we are able to see and able to touch from in that computer. That part is called as a hardware devices. Under this hardware devices, they are classified into four. First one is input device, second output device, third storage device, finally central processing unit. Today we are going to learn only about the input devices. What is this input device will accept the input from the user and it will be converted into the form of the computer can understand. Computer only can understand zeros and one. What are the things we are giving, the text format, the number format, it won't be understand. It only understand the machine code language, zeros and ones. So these input devices specially used for the supermarket, bank and etc. So let's see some of the input devices. First one is barcode reader. You may have seen this code or printed lines like grocery items and cloth. Have you seen this barcode anywhere? Sure, everybody can see these things. What is the use of this code mean? This code represents the product information such as the price, place where they manufacture these items and are having in this code. Usually the cashier use this barcode reader to scan the barcode on each purchase item, which gets the input into the computer. The computer use the barcode to identify the product. These are the process. Next one is the MACR. MACR is nothing, is a magnetic ink character reader. This is specially used machine for the banking purpose. This machine have the magnetic particle of iron oxide. So this were used to check and marking the identify the check and marking the check. Check usually have the check number, bank code and branch code. This will print in the magnetic ink format. So the information is scanned by the MACR and the check are sorted city wise or branch wise. Hereafter, if you are going to the bank, check it how the MACR is working, what are the things were done by using this MACR. OCR. OCR is nothing, optical character reader. This device is used to scan the normal printed or handwritten text. The device first will scan the handwritten or printed text. After scanning, the text will be converted into image format. After that, the character recognition software convert the image into code. Okay, inside this machine, character recognition software is available. Okay, so after converting the text into image, inside the software will convert the image into character code. Why need? Only that character code only the machine can understandable. So after understanding everything, it will store inside the machine. After that, it will be converted into the computer. This process is called as the optical character recognition process. Mean OMR. Have you heard the OMR sheet? Where we are using this OMR sheet? Want to see the sheet? This is the OMR sheet. Everyone heard the OMR sheet. Mostly it is used for the objective type exam. Am I right? With the boxes or circle that can be filled with a dark pencil or ink. Why we are marking as a dark pencil or ink? It will be why mean this sheet is scanned by one reader. That machine is called the OMR reader machine. It will scan the machine. From the machine, one light beam will be passed through this sheet into the sheet. The marked area reflected less light than the unmarked area. So this is the way the machine identifies the answer. It is commonly used for checking the answer sheet of the multiple choice question. CORD reader. This is used to read the information which is stored on CORD, such as magnetic strip card. It is nothing but magnetic strip card means our credit card. This is called the magnetic strip card. In this credit card, all the information, the number, format and the character, everything is in the form of the information is stored in the magnetically. So if you swipe the card through this magnetic character reader machine, it will read all the information quickly and accurately. So damages also be taken place of this card, like physical damage, otherwise due to the water liquid, these can be destroyed the information on the card. These are the some example of the input devices. Today we are learning type of the computer by size, and from the cardboard devices we learn the part of the input device. I hope you guys you understand this chapter well. The whole world is depending only the computer. Without this, nothing will possible. So please update yourself, search more electronic device and learn new things. work is done, it's time to say thank you. Be safe and learn today's portion. Meet you at another interesting topic. Thank you.